Investigators tell us they think an illegal firework started that fire and blew up overnight to 3,200 acres. It's burning in the Columbia River Gorge, about a half mile from Cascade Locks. Our Eileen Park has been following firefighting efforts today and joins us live with the latest.
Dan, just in the last couple of minutes, we got an idea of what firefighters are dealing with. Just over my shoulder, we saw a small fire start on that ridge, and it has quickly spread to what you are seeing now. All of this coming dangerously close to people's homes.
I'd never imagined in a million years that it would happen.
Brandon Logue has lived in Cascade Locks his entire life.
Heartbreaking, really. I mean, there's just so much to love here, and it's really heartbreaking.
His family received a level 2 evacuation notice, which means they have to be ready to leave at a moment's notice. But he's holding out. So are you ready to go?
No, I'm not.
Why?
Like I said, everything's here. I mean, I'm not ready to go. I'm not ready to see this place go. But for family's sake, I mean, I will go if need be.
But you're holding out until the last minute.
Basically, yes.
The Eagle Creek fire already destroyed 3,000 acres. So far, there's no containment.
I mean, what can you do? I mean, there's nothing you can do. Just get everything ready and go.
Blaine Fanning is staying at a Red Cross shelter in Stevenson, Washington. He was one of a couple hundred people told to evacuate.
About 5:30 in the morning, the county sheriff was knocking on the door, wanting us to leave.
Meanwhile, a number of popular trails in the gorge have been closed indefinitely.
The Wakala Falls trailhead is closed. The Tooth Rocks trailhead is closed. Exit 41 is closed. Old Highway 30, which is the scenic highway that a lot of hikers and bikers like to use, is closed. And I've been told from Ainsworth to Wyatt, the trails are closed.
Again, investigators believe the Eagle Creek fire was started from fireworks. They have a suspect they're questioning, but they have not released that person's name. Also, just a few minutes ago, I spoke with fire investigators, and they tell me the level 1, level 2, and level 3 evacuation notices for different towns in Hood River County could change. So we'll keep you posted about that, especially considering how quickly this fire is spreading. All of this could be rapidly changing in the next couple of hours.